clothed me with flesh and skin, and hast faced me with bones and sinews. Sinew is me shifa, bones is me fupa. Ngozini, skin. That is what? Flesh is yeah. So Job is saying, you have clothed me, in other words, you have given me a cloth of skin and flesh, and you have faced me, surrounded me with bones and sinews. Tumefahamu hiyo kizungu kwanza? Anasema umenizingira na mifupa na mishipa na the next thing I say is this. Na umenivalisha ngozi na nyama. So in other words, he's speaking about his body. What this man is saying, the body you have given me is like a cloth. So the question I want to ask you, are you the body? Are you your body? Ayubu anasema umenivalisha ngozi na nyama na umenizingira na mifupa na mishipa. Swali ninauliza ni wewe sasa ni mwili? Wewe ni ngozi? Wewe ni nyama? Wewe ni mifupa ama mishipa? Wewe ni nani? That is this physical body that is we are always looking at is not what we are. For your formation, when somebody dies, the skins, the body, the flesh, everything is there. See you. Na hiyo ndio nawe kwa nini? Na wakati mtu anakufa, mnamuona kitoka kwa hiyo mwili. Is it possible to see? Is it possible to see? Even if somebody dies, like there's a time I was in this hospital last year, and somebody's grandmother died. I was there. And then when we were there, she had a problem of breathing. So they brought the oxygen box, they fixed it on her. But it's not too kidogo, but she has been in hospital for almost more than a week. But that day, I think she was to die. Then when people were surrounding her, we were also there. Nakuta tu miguu imeanza ku. You see what I'm doing, you see what I'm doing. So the legs are just, and the hands are, and people began screaming because they knew she's leaving the body. And in less than 1 minute, she was quiet. So they knew when the legs were moving, she was leaving the body. But then nobody saw her. Now what I'm simply saying is this. You are a spirit that is in the body. You're not this body. You are a spirit in the body. So that even when you die, it is the spirit that leaves the body. So which one is most important, the spirit or the body?
Spirit.
Understanding and developing the hidden man of the heart. You have heard of that? That's what the Bible is all about. Understanding the hidden man of the heart. We're talking about the spirit. Now, you've heard of so many people in the church talking about God looks at the heart. Are you aware of that? Mungu anaangalia nini? Why you only lie? Those who are who speak about it, say that. Why come out? And what's when you want to say, Mahumba, that is Zama? Even the English people say, now in 1 Samuel chapter number 16, verse 7, the Bible says, God looks at the heart, but not the physical state of man. Which is this heart?
We are all coming from church. Tunasikiza mafundisho kila siku kwa misa. Which is this hand? And you know what the scripture is talking about, how to be point where? Is that what you normally do? Si tunasukuma kidole hapo. I know it's there for you who have done biology. I know you didn't do biology, so you don't know. Then when you mess up, who's your heart?
Unasukuma mpaka hapa.
Does God look at how that physical organ is pumping blood?
So that he looks at how the pumps are, the blood are pumped, kuna nye, kuna oxygen, kuna nye ina. Sasa anajaribu kuangalia kunia, kuna imegia.
Does he look at that? What does God look at when he says, when you talk about the heart? That God looks at the heart, what are we talking about? We're talking about that spirit, person. You are spirit. And that's what the Bible calls heart. Just a brief explanation of what I'm saying right now. Now, right now, each one of you, kila moja wenu mko kwa dunia yenu. Am I speaking the truth? Huh? Is there anybody here who knows what is happening in somebody's heart right now? Or let me put this. Is there anybody here who knows what somebody who's next to him is thinking? That is the person I'm talking about. And have you ever seen that person? Right now, when you have a car, you can have a car. Have you seen that person? Are you seeing that person? You already paid for the job. I don't know if you already have got my lesson. The last how many minutes? Was it 15 minutes or how many minutes that I've been teaching? And everybody has already paid. Do you see somebody sitting next to you?
No.
Kama ngozi na nyama ni nguo. Mifupa na mishipa ni fence yenye imemzingira huyo mtu na wewe ni yeye unaona. You want to be failed by example. Then you need to have a discipleship exam every time. Do you see that person?
No.
This is my head. Am I the head?
No.
This is my? Now, have you seen me? Are you seeing me? Because if I die, I will just pack this body right to somewhere and I disappear out of it. And then you begin saying, rest in peace. But the body is still there. You know, when you read this chapter 1, when I say desire, revelation, knowledge, this is what I'm talking about. All humans on the face of the earth have never known who they are. And they have been concentrating a lot on the physical. Budget yako, inaishia wapi, nyingi ayo budget yako, like you are given how much? Don't to give me the amount. Wakati unakuja hapa, okay, money ni gapi? Na zote zinaenda wapi?
Inaenda
kwa mwili. Inaenda kwako? Yote inaenda kwa mwili. You are taking Vaseline, unanunua lotion, talk about this. You know the things you normally buy. But it is taking care of the ghosts in the flesh, the bones and them. It is taking care of your house. This is not your house. This, in a few minutes, we'll see something. All that budget is being consumed by what? And the very body will fix it in the ground sometimes to come. And God is not so impressed about how we are taking care of your body. I'm not saying taking care of your body is bad. But it's something I want to show you.
Now, you've learned that your spirit, are we together? That lives in the body, in the physical body. Now, let's progress to the next level. We go to chapter two. Let's go to chapter two. Genesis chapter 1 verse 26. The creation of man. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air. What is happening? You didn't hear what I said? Genesis chapter 1 verse 26. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, God created him. Male and female created he them. To notice something in the above verse. There is the creation and making of man. When we talk about creating something, we've been not using previously existing material. The created man is not a synthetic man. Now, a synthetic man, the word synthetic simply means a material, something that is visible. The created man is not something that is visible, that can be seen physically. What I've just explained, what I remember in chapter 1. This man that is created is a spirit. He's not physical. The Hebrew text shows us that God produced man without referring to any previously existing material. The Greek word used for created is bara. It means God generated Adam from inexistent material. This is a spiritual creation. It means creating something anew. This is where human spirit came from. Man came out of God. Now, the word create, as we have just explained, simply means bringing something out of nothing. You know what nothing is? You bring something out of nothing. And I have, all of us are spiritual people, are born again. Some may understand what spiritual one is. In other words, the Bible talks about how the word that is seen came out of the what is unseen. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. The word that is seen came from something that is not seen. Now, when we talk about God creating man at this point, what we are saying is God brought man out of himself. Is God seen? Do you see God? God is spirit. He created man out of himself. God is not seen. But he created man out of himself, which is a spirit. He's a spirit. He's not something of this nature that can be physically seen. Accessibility. To bring something out of nothing in Jesus' name. Amen. You know what I mean is, God is a creator. And he has made a man can become also a creator. You can create something that has never existed in the world. And that's my desire in Masabit County. I want to bring things that has never been. But it's my desire. And I always dream and I see something. He created man out of nothing. And this creation we are talking about is, we are talking about this spirit
called the man. Nimekuuliza size na kuuliza unaona mwenzako kaniambia uone. Enye unaona ni mwili yake. Enye